Now let us discuss about Mendel's third law, that is law of independent assortment. When Mendel performed his first monohybrid cross, he was eager to know what is going to happen if it's going to have two characteristics at a time. You know, when we have two characteristics at a time, we are discussing that cross which considers two characteristics simultaneously. That cross is known as a dihybrid cross, because di means two, two characters at a time, that is dihybrid cross. So based on this dihybrid cross, Mendel gave his law, that is law of independent assortment. Let us read the statement, and when we'll perform the cross, when we'll get the results of the cross, we'll interpret what this statement implies, right? So let us start. The alleles of different characters located in different pairs of homologous chromosomes, okay, the alleles of different characters, means here the word different characters is used, right? So we have alleles of different characters, means for example, we can say that one way we are going to talk about black hair, and other way we are going to talk about long hair and short hair. Black hair, brown hair, long hair, short hair. So alleles of different characters located in different pair of homologous chromosome, and we have different pairs of homologous chromosomes like this. This is just for your understanding. So if we have alleles of different characters located on different pair of homologous chromosomes are independent of one another in their segregation during gamete formation and in coming together into the offspring by fertilization, both processes occurring randomly. So when gametes are formed, right, and when these homologous chromosomes during segregation, what is going to happen is this characteristic allele going to affect this or not, right? This was a question that was raised in Mendel's mind. So by performing this cross, dihybrid cross, Mendel answered these questions. So whenever we have two different characteristics, whenever we have alleles which are referring to two different characteristics, and when they segregate during gamete formation, the results obtained will be like that they are independent of each other, right? These homologous chromosomes, these alleles are independent of one another. How this is going to happen, we'll understand by this dihybrid cross. So we'll first perform that cross and then we'll interpret. But before that, let me read the alternative statement for this Mendel's third law. During the formation of gametes in each sex, either one of a pair of alleles may enter the same gamete combined randomly with either one of another pair, right? So let us understand by this dihybrid cross how we're going to reach to this statement and how Mendel gave this law. So let us start. We are going to discuss by a cross in case of a pea plant as Mendel did. So we have round seeds. This is pure true line trait. So round seeds, yellow cotyledons, okay, wrinkled seeds and green cotyledons. So Mendel did a cross between a plant which was homozygous for round seeds, yellow cotyledons, wrinkled seeds, green cotyledons. So before I move further, I hope that you all remember that when we are going to talk about the dominant characteristics, we'll use an uppercase letter, a capital letter. When we talk about recessive, we'll deal it with what? Lowercase letter, means small letters. So round seeds are dominant over wrinkled seeds, and then we have what? We have yellow cotyledons which are dominant over green cotyledons. So this is how, when Mendel crossed between these two plants, the first type of progeny he is going to obtain is, you all know, from this pair we can have only a capital R. From this pair, we can have again only capital Y. Next, from this pair also, we can only have small r. This is a possible combination, this is a possible gamete which will be there. Then from this pair, we can have only small y. Because it is homozygous for round seeds, this is homozygous for yellow cotyledons, this is homozygous for wrinkled seeds, this is homozygous for green cotyledons. So this is the gametes which we'll having, they will be having these pairs, right? What is going to happen in the progeny? We'll write progeny for B, and here we can write parents. This is how you'll make a cross, right? This is the parents and these are the gametes. So what is going to happen in the progeny? That is the combination capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, right? So this is the possible explanation of the progeny. The progeny will have capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So as you can see, it has that recessive gene also, but since the dominant allele is present, since the dominant group is present, what is going to happen? The dominant characteristic trait will be expressed. And what is the dominant characteristic trait? Dominant characteristic trait is round seeds and which cotyledons? Yellow cotyledons. So we have round seeds, yellow cotyledons. So now you can make out how this is going to happen. Mendel in his dihybrid cross took two characteristics at a time. He took round seeds and yellow cotyledons, mean plant having round seeds and yellow cotyledons, and crossed it with plant with what? Wrinkled seeds and green cotyledons. So these are the gametes which will be there, and in the progeny will be formed, which will be from superficial terms, it will be what? It will be round seeds, yellow cotton. When I say the word superficial, means from the outer appearance, the plant will have round seeds and yellow cotyledons. So this is how the progeny will be, with round seeds and yellow cotyledons. But when for the second generation, what Mendel did selfing. Okay, we can write it here as selfing. What is selfing? Selfing means the progeny which he obtained, he crossed it with the same progeny. The plants he obtained as a progeny, he selfed it, means he crossed it with the same type. So what is going to happen? We are going to have now different combinations. Let us see what sort of combinations we can have. We can have combinations as capital R, capital Y, right? Capital R, capital Y. We can also have small r, capital Y. We can also have capital R, small y. And we can also have small r, small y. So what are these conveying, right? These are the four possible outcomes that we can have. These are the four possible traits that can we see. So remember, till now what we have done is we have taken the plants and we have considered two characteristics at a time. Round seeds with yellow cotyledons, wrinkled seeds with green cotyledons. Remember, the uppercase letter shows the dominant characteristic. So when I'm talking about capital R, means this is a dominant characteristic trait, means round seeds are dominant over wrinkled seeds and yellow cotyledons are dominant over green cotyledons. So it's a cross between a plant having round seeds and yellow cotyledons with a plant having wrinkled seeds with green cotyledons. Okay, so in the progeny initially we had round seeds and yellow cotyledons, because the dominant characteristic trait is present, and when the dominant allele is present, the recessive allele will not be able to express itself. So the progeny, from outer appearance, from superficially, it will look like having round seeds with yellow cotyledons, but since it has these alleles for recessive character also, they will be expressed later on. So when Mendel did selfing for the next generation, what is going to happen? We have these four possible combinations: capital R, capital Y, small r, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, small y. So next, we'll solve this cross by a Punnett square.